Hey guys, welcome back. My name is Veena Asmano from veenaasmano.com. Today I'm sharing with you a recipe for cheese stuffed chicken breast. Now this is a very simple, very easy recipe. I like to use goat cheese. It has a wonderful unique flavor, but if you don't like goat cheese, you can use any other cheese, and I'll leave all the details for that on my blog. Now this is chicken breast. Now I don't make it in the oven. I make it on the gas stove and on the stovetop, and it's a very simple and easy way to do it. In fact, I even add a little bit of water just to make sure that it does not dry out. Okay, so I'm going to make sure that you have a wonderful moist chicken breast, and I'll show you the tricks I use. So let's get started. Don't forget, you'll get the list of ingredients with progress pictures for this on my blog, and I'll leave the link below. I'm going to start by making a pocket in my chicken breast, and as you can see, just put your hand right on top and give it a nice clean cut, and it becomes a nice little pocket. If you want, you can cut up a little more than so that you have enough space to put the filling in. Now it's very important that you do not slit it right through on the other side, otherwise all the filling will come out from the other sides. Now, a good tip would be to place paper hand towels under the breast so that way they don't move on you, because chicken breast is slippery and so is the tray. Now, I've got in a bowl some goat cheese. I'm using a nice quality crumbled goat cheese. This is homemade goat cheese, which I buy locally. I'm using Parmesan and cheddar, onion flakes, and some garlic powder for flavor. I've got some salt, pepper, and some parsley. I'm not using salt because there's enough salt in the goat cheese and Parmesan. I've got some sour cream to help bring it all together. Now if you don't like goat cheese, you can use other cheese as well, and I'll leave details for that on my blog. Don't forget, you've got progress pictures for this on my blog as well, so I hope you will visit my blog. And I'm going to put this aside, and I'm going to season this chicken with salt and pepper. Now it is very important to season the chicken well, salt and pepper, but don't over salt the chicken, because we do have salt in the cheese as well. So while you do want to make sure that you have a nice seasoning on the chicken breast, you do not want to over season it. And there you go. Now all we have to do is stuff the chicken with some of the stuffing that I have. You want to make sure that you have a nice spread inside, okay, very lightly. Once we've done that, we are going to take some toothpicks and secure the. Now, I like a good filling, but again, it's up to you how much you want. This is good enough for two breasts, okay. Some of it will melt, but now you can see I'm using my cocktails toothpicks to just secure the chicken breast. If you have not subscribed for my video, for my channel, I highly would encourage you to do that. Now I'm going to post some more amazing recipes very soon. Don't forget to, of course, give this video a thumbs up. And if you do like my video, don't forget to let me know in the comments. I'd love to know if you try any of my recipes. Next, I'm going to coat the chicken in flour. The flour is going to give us a nice color when we cook it, and it's also kind of going to thicken the sauce a little bit so that we have a little bit of juices in the pan, and that's going to help thicken it as well. I'm going to show you now. Now you can leave this in the fridge until you're ready to cook it, but I'm going to do it right now. I've got a skillet with a little bit of oil and some butter. The butter gives us a nice, beautiful golden color, while the oil prevents the butter from burning. So I'm going to add the chicken breast right in there, and I'm going to cook it for about a minute on each side on high so that I get a nice color first. Once I get the color, I'm going to then reduce the heat and cook it for about 8 to 10 minutes, but I'm also going to add in a little bit of water. This is going to prevent the butter from burning any further, and it's also going to help the chicken keep nice and moist. So I'm going to add a little bit of water, not too much, and I'm going to cover the pan. This is going to help my chicken nicely cook right through, because remember, we have a nice big fat chicken breast which has got to cook right through, otherwise the center will not be cooked, because this is a double-sided. So you want to make sure that you cook it right through for about 8 to 10 minutes, and you can baste it if you want, but the flour thickens the sauce of the butter sauce that is in the pan. It tastes absolutely delicious. Now this is all that done and ready to go. We can serve this with over mashed potato, over buttered noodles. I'm doing some salad today, and I've got some nice beautiful grapes inside my salad, and that's all I'm going to serve for myself. The kids are going to have some mashed potato with this later, and I hope you try this recipe. It's very simple and very easy. If you don't like goat cheese, try another cheese, but it's definitely worth a try. You see the sauce? It's absolutely delicious. I'm going to cut this up for you. Sorry about my hand. Okay, there you see all the goat cheese right in the middle. It still has a nice goat cheese filling in the middle. Thank you so much for joining me. I hope you enjoyed this recipe. If you did, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, and of course subscribe and hit the notification bell for more videos. I'll see you on another video. Bye bye for now.